Welcome. I'm Prerna from BW Business World. Today we have with us a corporate honcho, Mr. Sameer Modi, who is the Managing Director of Modi Enterprises. Mr. Modi has launched various initiatives for the Modi Group, including Modi Care, cosmetics brand Color Bar, and convenience store 24/7. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Found almost 9 years ago, Modi Enterprises has impacted various lives through its products and services. What is your vision for the company?
Well, I think 90 years ago, when my grandfather started the group, his vision was to be global. He said that if you can't make the best, tie up with the best. And my vision is really that, to be the best. Not tie up with the best companies, but make the best products in India that we can take all across the world. And I think that to bring back the Modi Group to the halo it used to have 50, 60 years ago.
So you launched Modi Care that has been in the market for 2 decades. What was the idea behind that? What is your target audience for the company and what kind of response have you seen till now?
When I started the company, we looked at all over the world how people were living and we found that direct selling was a big changer in the economies. And I researched between Japan, Australia, Thailand, US, and I found that large amount of income and freedom was coming there. So the idea was to give freedom and make people's dream come true. And people used to go to the temples, right? Say, Bhagwan mujhe ye de do, Bhagwan mujhe wo de do. And our idea was the God decide within us. And if you have a dream, then you come to us and we'll fulfill the dream. And the products that we bought about were everyday products. And today the response is fantastic. I think that we got about 2.5 lakh people joining every month. We have 7,500 centers. And we're giving large amounts of freedom. Our top earner is earning about 9 crore rupees a year. So we're changing lives of everyday people. A person who drove a bicycle last month bought a Mercedes. So you see that if you have a dream, you have a vision, then we are able to provide you the vehicle to get there. So response has been fantastic, soon we'll be number one. But number one is not enough. My question is, how many people's lives do you touch and how many dreams do you fulfill? That is the goal in Modi Care, to fulfill people's lives with happiness, with success, with joy and money.
As you mentioned that you are changing the lives of people, so you offer various exciting programs and promotions. How can one avail that? Please tell us in detail about that.
Well, firstly, we only sell one product, that is Azadi. And I have a concept called Soch Badlo, Khud Ko Badlo, Dunya Badlo. So all the programs that we do, one is a program we do to explain you the business. Second program we do is hold your hand for 90 days. And third, which is the most important program, is interaction with me, which is really talking about living life, live the Modi way. It's not talking about what's your bank account, what's your title is, but really that live life for today, plan for tomorrow. But live life today, live it to the fullest, because you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. So everything that we do is catered around this concept. So whether it's our promotions, whether it's our product, whether it's our events, everything caters around this Azadi piece, which is very different from other people, other direct selling companies. Either they are small companies that want to make a quick buck, or they're binary plans. But for us, we've been here 90 years. We have the Modi legacy behind us. So for me, it's pertinent that success happens. Therefore, they have 91-92% attrition every year. We are not happy where we are. But even then, we are 8 times what the industry average is. So that's just showing that we are bringing change in India. And I am hardcore Indian, Bharatiya, Bharat. So for me, all of that is important. And legacy helps.
Alright, so please tell us about the revenue model of Modi Care.
So Modi Care revenue model, first revenue is how do I get the person who's coming in to make money. So we have a high compensation plan, we have products that work. So firstly, our products need to perform better than anything that's in the market. Second, we give a back-to-back satisfaction guarantee that if you're not satisfied for any reason, you can exchange the product or take your money. So that is the first revenue model for the consultant who goes and promotes the product, saying that there's a good product and we have full satisfaction guarantee. Second is layered commissions. So we pay about 62% out there, which is the highest in the industry. And then what is left in the end, I will say that's my money. For me, money for Modi care is not important. Money in the hands of the common man is most important. Thankfully, because Modi care doesn't pay for my lifestyle, doesn't pay for my clothes or the house I live in. But I want Modi care to build India. And that's the revenue model right now. Build India, build India, build India. Give Azadi, give Azadi, give Azadi.
All right. What are your expansion plans for Modi care?
Well, we want to go international. So we're looking at Nepal, we're looking at Bangladesh, we're looking at the UAE, and we're looking at England. Now people say, why England? The British ruled over us, I want to rule over the British.
That sounds perfect. So how soon can we expect that?
Well, this year we are already getting ready to do our registrations, companies have been formed. So I think that Nepal, Bangladesh, UAE and the UK will happen in the course of 2021.
So talking about another brand, you also launched Colorbar, the cosmetic brand. How do you compete with the other renowned leaders in the industry?
Well, firstly, Colorbar has a different philosophy. The philosophy of Colorbar is right based on palette. You know, the concept of palette, that when you get a second look. So our question is, can you be your own palette? So we think the day you feel good in front of the mirror, the day goes very well. So we think, can we make that 100% true for you? Secondly, in terms of formulations and performance of the product, we buy all our products from abroad. So Germany, Italy, France, Korea, Switzerland and the US. And we say the products that are made by luxury brands, like likes of NARS, Bobby Brown, Urban Decay, Chanel, MAC, Charlotte Tilbury, Huda. These are brands we buy the same product from the same manufacturer. But we think the pricing of these products are in likes of your Lakme and Revlons. So buy, pay cheap, but buy expensive. I mean, we are the starting point of luxury. And we're finding that we are now the third largest brand in the country. We are growing at about 40% CAGR. And that's because of the products we give.
Okay, the brand is also revamping as of now. So what was the need for the same? And what kind of new offers, products, pricing are we going to see?
Well, I believe in the philosophy, change is the only constant. And 2 years ago, we looked at our products, we looked at our branding and we said, we want to go international. Can we be the best? So that's what came about, the branding change. Then we looked at color, the color change. And then we said, we want to give the experience to be as though you walked into a luxury store. You walked into a Tom Ford or a Gucci or a Louis Vuitton store. The same experience we want to give you in our stores. So that's what the new look is coming into. Very, very prestigious, high-end. We also bring a lot of bespoke that you can make your own lipsticks. We have right now 1,080 shades you can make in our store with your own fragrance. And in 15 minutes, you can take your personalized lipstick. We bring in a personalized foundation. We bring in personalized nail polish. So that's the offering we're bringing in. We launch about 300 SKUs every year. We do two kinds of products. One that nobody has in the world. And two, the luxury brands have in the world. Pricing-wise, we're not going to change our pricing model. Again, price to sell. Money will come.
What is the last year revenue of Colorbar and what are your expectations for the current fiscal year?
So last year, we closed the year at 330 crores. And this year, we're looking at close to 450 crores. And again, growth is happening. More and more people are coming in. The revamp is helping. New product launches are helping. So overall, my goal is again here to be international. I want to go the next couple of years all across the world.
So what will you say? That how do you stay ahead of the trend? Like what is coming in the market? How do you, you know, plan it out for your own brands?
Well, one is that we look at trends that are coming in, which are already released 1 year prior. Secondly, since we are working with the international players who make for these international brands, we know what they're launching, we know what they're developing. And we do the first advantage. A product when introduced by these manufacturers takes 2 years to come to market. We want to come in 6 months to a year. And for example, 2020-21 is done. 21-22 is where we are right now focusing on, because the lead time to develop a product is 6 months to a year. Okay. So we are very comfortable, we are trendsetters, we're known for innovation. We are the only brand in the world that has two Guinness World Records. We broke one and created one last year. So we are, again, challenge the industry, do things differently, and be your own animal. So we're not followers, but we're creators.
That's actually impressive. Talking about another brainchild of yours, the convenience store 24/7. What was the idea behind it?
Well, again, as you travel the world, you see the likes of 7-Eleven, Family Mart, Circle K. You want a drink at night, you can go there. You want a sandwich, you want top up your mobile phone. India didn't have that. India, the concept was, bhai 11 baje ke baad koi jata hi nahi bahar. So I said, let's try it. And the blessing of the late Chief Minister Sheila Dixit, I went to her and said, ma'am, we want to launch this kind of store. And she said, great, I want something like this in my city. And that's how the store came about, to give ultimate convenience, be open 24 hours, 365 days a year. And the name connotation 24/7 connotes it very, very, very clearly, 24 hours, 7 days a week. And our logo had the owl. So owl did one thing. One thing, it says we are open at night. Second, according to Indian mythology, the owl is the harbinger of good news. So both combined together with 24/7, I think that it was a good way to go.
What are your expansion plans for the convenience store?
We are right now on a hold to stabilize the business. And we're looking at to open another 200-250 stores next year. But our goal is to be all across India. I think India can take at least 50,000 stores.
All right. Talking about all the three companies, what are your goals for coming 3 to 5 years for all of them?
To make change. The common goal is to build change. The common goal is to motivate. I believe in the concept called Samirness. I empower my employees, their family members. But really, go global, make a difference, make an impact, and change the thinking. Soch badlo, khud ko badlo, dunya badlo. And I am fully confident that in 3 to 5 years, all three companies will be a global name.
Thank you so much for talking with us, sir. I hope people get inspired and they are actually enlightened by watching this.
Thank you. Thank you for having us here.